listening to Prank Calls Only with Leon Haberdashery.
Here we go!
This is Leon. Leon, motherfucker.
I'm not a little pipsqueak, motherfucker.
Oh, you gonna stop at the Dairy Queen and bring me an ice cream cake?
You got it, motherfucker. I sure the fuck am. Can you believe they're still together? All the shit they've been through?
Who?
Your butt cheeks.
You want to get fought through the fucking phone, bro?
I got a new tattoo. It says, it's on my neck, and it says NyQuil. You know why?
No way.
Because I'm a cold killer.
We're sorry, you have reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service. If you feel you have reached this recording in error, please check the number and try your call again.
Motherfucker.
I don't know who I'm speaking with, but you're probably expired your damn self.
You've been repeating the same stuff, sir. I don't know.
If you prank calling me, you won.
While I'm at it, how about I hand you a couple of bullets to the body? Paramedics haul you away into a hospital, you know, ICU, hook up on a ventilator. How about that? Would you like that?
Are you done or are you finished? Okay, I'm listening to the worst prank call show ever.
You're listening to the worst prank call in the world from Leon Haberdashery.
What up, motherfuckers? It's Leon. And you're listening to another episode of Prank Calls with Leon Haberdashery. Sorry for the lack of content lately. I've been busy as fuck. But no excuses or long intros. Here's a short little episode to make up. Let's go.
Hello?
Is this Big Fat Kenneth?
Say that again.
I'm looking for Big Fat Rotund Kenneth.
Well, you got the wrong one.
This is not Mr.
This Mr.
Oh, hi. My name is Leon. I'm calling from Republic Services. I'm your new trash carrier.
Uh-huh.
Right, so the city contracted us to pick up your trash on Tuesdays.
Oh, you're going to pick it up tomorrow?
Correct.
Okay, it's already out.
How long has it been out there?
Since Wednesday.
Could you tell that man in the background to maybe just pipe down and shut the fuck up? We're trying to handle business.
No, it's already out. It's been out ever since Wednesday.
Right. Okay, great. So at 6 a.m., what we're going to need you to do is come on out to the curb yourself and just put yourself in that truck.
So, okay, I'll be out there.
We're going to throw you away, sir.
That's fine.
Okay. And that motherfucker in the background making all that noise.
Okay.
Yeah, so make sure that you're out there at 6 a.m. with the trash. Don't be late or we'll come in there and get you.
Oh, you'll come and get me, huh?
Oh, yeah. We'll knock on your door, and we'll come in there, and we'll pull you out of that bed, and we'll throw you in this trash canister.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Are you drinking tonight, sir?
Am I drinking today?
Yeah. Are you drinking? Are you drinking?
Yeah, I'm drinking.
You sound like...
Yeah. I'm a beer drinker.
Ooh, what kind of beer are you drinking?
A&W.
A&W? That's a root beer, ain't it?
That's what I drink.
Oh, so you sugar high. You ain't drunk.
Well, yeah.
Who's that guy in the background? Yeah. Is that your son?
No.
Let me talk to that fool, please. It,
you want to talk to him?
Yeah, let me talk to that fool. He sounds like he's ripe and ready.
Hello?
Hello, young man. How are you?
All right.
You're being real disrespectful. Well, that old gentleman is trying to have a conversation with the trash service. We're trying to square away some business, and you're carrying on in the background, hooping and hollering.
Who is okay? May I ask you who I'm speaking with?
My name is Leon. I'm your trash professional. I'm in charge of making sure that your trash gets carried away on a timely matter.
Right. Well, it sure didn't get carried away Thursday when it was supposed to be.
And you know what's funny about that, sir? I can make sure that it doesn't get carried away this Thursday. That's
well,
the kind
you
of,
know what?
That's the kind
all,
of power
that's
I hold.
All right with it. That's all right with me because it's been going on since forever anyway. So what you say don't make or break nothing.
Oh. So anything what we're going to ask is that you and your pops, I think that might have been, and your friend, your old drinking buddy, we're just going to ask that both of y'all are standing out at the curb at 6 a.m. with the trash so we can collect you with it.
Okay, well, you said 6 o'clock?
6 in the morning. We're throwing you away, sir.
Okay, 6 in the morning.
Yeah. Mushmouths like you. All mushmouths like you got to get in the bed.
Well, it's a whole bunch of us there.
You've
it's
expired,
a whole
sir.
Bunch of us.
You have expired.
It's a whole bunch of us. You probably are, too. I don't know who I'm speaking with, but you're probably expired your damn self.
No, my name is Leon. I'm very fresh, ripe, and ready. I thought you were ripe
okay.
and ready, but, sir, you are definitely expired.
Okay, well, I feel like I'm talking to somebody expired, so.
How many of y'all are living there in that home?
Living where?
In that home of yours.
How many of y'all are living there?
Yeah, how many of y'all are living in that home?
Yeah, and I'm asking how many of y'all are living there.
Oh, I don't live there.
Home.
I'm in a call center, sir.
Okay, well, so am I.
Are you in a call center right
now? I'm in a call center as we speak.
Oh, well, shit.
Yeah, threw you one, didn't I? You just didn't know that. You just don't know who you're talking to, do you?
I guess not. What's your name, young man?
It don't even matter. What's your name?
My name is Leon, and you sound kind of like a guy that's like comparative to Greek yogurt that's been left out in a car on a hot summer's day, and it's all bubbly and ran over and ruined.
And you know, you sound like some young dealer.
Yeah.
A 100 degree day that was left out there on the highway for hours and on top of hours with a bloated stomach. If you pop him with your fingernail, poked him with your fingernail, he'll pop all the way over, smelling miles and miles and miles and miles away.
Right.
And that's just from a deer. Yeah. So you're probably equivalent to that.
Oh, okay. Nice. All I could make out was the equivalent of that. So please don't say that
okay,
again.
Well, then, to somebody else who has patience.
Does your brother bark?
It's sense enough to listen to you.
Do you have a brother that barks, sir?
A brother that barks?
Yeah.
A couple of them. A couple of them. And from time to time, I'll bark.
Really? Give me a bark. Look at me. Ooh, that was nice. Good boy. Now you calm down.
Good boy.
Exactly. Calm down, big boy. You got excited and got carried away on me. I don't got no snacks. I don't got no treats. Do you think I could get a drop out of you?
What's a drop?
So you're just gonna repeat after me? And you're going to say something like,
okay.
You're listening to the worst prank call show ever with Leon Haberdashery.
Haberdashery?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do it.
You're listening to the worst prank call in the world from Leon Haberdashery.
Yeah, that's it. You did it. So I don't got shit to do with your trash, man. I wouldn't put shit outside. I'm just calling, fucking around.
Which means when I wake up in the morning, my trash still will be there.
It's them motherfuckers. I don't know when they're coming, man. They're just bullshit.
Well, this has been probably the worst prank joke.
Yeah.
I thought at least out of all this shit,
you thought you was gonna get your shit picked up.
My trash picked up tomorrow.
Hell no.
So this has got to be the worst prank joke.
Yep.
In all my 50 years of living.
Yep. That's it. You got it. You just good luck. Good luck. I hope they come around and get it soon.
All right, then.
The trash can stay, but you and your brother got to go.
That's not my brother. That's my dad.
Oh, that's what I thought. He's a cool old man.
I'm a cool old man?
No, he's a cool old guy. You cool too, man.
He's the cool old guy?
Yeah.
And I'm not?
Yeah, you're all right, man. You're okay. He's cooler, though.
Okay, reveal yourself, because this shit crazy.
LeonHaberdashery.com. I got to go.
Leon Haberdashery. Could you text all that to this phone so I can see that so I can personally say that?
I don't know if I can. You got to look it up. You got to do the work, man. LeonHaberdashery.com. But I got to go. I love Haberdashery.
Haberdashery?
Yeah, Haberdashery.
Haberdashery.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Google it. I got to go. I love you.
Hello?
Oh, hello. Is this Big Fat Porsche?
Who is this?
My name is Leon. I'm your neighbor. On.
Uh-huh.
Is this Porsche?
Yeah, why? What's up?
Oh, yeah. So I came by over the weekend, and I was digging through your trash, and I actually collected a couple of items that I think you probably would want back.
What was that?
A lot of stuff with your name and number on it. I mean, personal stuff. There's an ID with your picture on it.
Why were you going through my trash?
Well, because you put it out on the curb. It was trash.
But that's weird because...
Well, anyway, that's not what's important. The stuff that I collected that I think you might want back is you know, I want to get it back to you. You know, there's...
Okay, so what are...
I'm sorry?
How did you find my number?
Well, I told you, it was written on some of the stuff in the trash. Is everything okay?
Okay, so when did you go through my...
This was like on Thursday. Is everything okay? You sound like you might be drinking or something.
Are you drinking?
No, I don't drink. I'm sober as hell.
So who are you?
My name is Leon. I'm your neighbor here up a couple of houses in the yellow one on... And yeah, so I was going through your trash. I thought we got through this, and I picked up some things.
Why were you going through my trash?
Because you put it on the curb.
My trash is not on the curb.
When I came by, it was on the curb, and that's when I
okay. Okay, so what's your address?
We don't need to go through all that. You don't need to know.
What do you mean we don't need to go through all of that?
I live in the yellow house.
What yellow house?
The yellow house on the street. Listen.
Which yellow house?
When you put your trash out on the curb, it's basically public property.
I didn't put my trash on the curb. Who are you, Leon? What's your last name?
Well, we're not gonna get into specifics like that.
What do you mean? You shouldn't have called my phone.
Well, I mean, you shouldn't have thrown away stuff with your number on it.
Like I said, who are you?
Okay, so I don't know how me explaining it over and over again is going to change the
fact. Okay, so what do you want from me? What do you want?
I
want
to come drop this stuff back off. I mean, there's just some things.
Why do you want to come to my house?
Well, I can leave it on your porch. I can leave it on the curb where it was, but it's got your ID.
You should have left it on the curb.
Listen. Judging by these tampons, number one, you need to take a Midol, woman. Number two.
First of all, Heffa, I don't got no Midols, bitch. I don't do the period. That's
what I said you need to take a Midol.
No, that's what you
Number
need.
Two, you need to calm down with that stink attitude. I'm just trying to get you your stuff back.
Number three,
take that tone out of your voice and talk to me.
I don't gotta take, come make me take the tone out of my voice.
I'm not gonna make you do anything.
Okay, then, so why were you going
through
my
trash? I'll start ripping this stuff up.
So go for it.
I'll start ripping this shit the fuck up. I don't care.
You think I'm going to be afraid?
I don't want you to be afraid. I thought you want this stuff back.
So what house are you at so I can come get it?
I'm going to bring it to you.
No, I'm going to come get it.
Were you trying to throw these pictures away, by the way? These pictures? There's a little picture book in this shit. I mean, I'm calling you to return stuff, and you're so ungrateful. You're giving me an attitude. I thought you would be happy.
Where you stay at so I can come get it?
I'm in the yellow house, and you're ungrateful as fuck, man.
Like, what yellow house?
You're blowing me right now. You're blowing me right now. Like,
what yellow house?
The only yellow house on the street.
I don't even know where you're talking about.
And I'm talking about these papers from social services. They look important, but I'm going to rip them up.
Rip them
this
up.
This is why people don't do nice shit no more, man, because of people like you.
Are you done or are you finished? Because clearly you didn't call from your direct phone number so that I can contact
this is my
you
number.
Back to cut your ass out.
You could curse me out now, but this is definitely my number.
What are you calling my phone for?
Because you threw this stuff away. There's a perfectly good onion, some underwear with your name on it.
Yep, those were cute as fuck.
I see why your man left you, and you got all these letters in this
But
bitch.
Too bad he didn't leave me because he's here, so I'm sorry for you.
There ain't no man in that house.
You right. It is. Come try.
There ain't no man in that house anywhere come near you.
Come try it then.
I'm not going to try nothing, but I know there ain't come no man that can deal with that attitude, honey.
Come try me then. I guarantee you. I don't want to try anything. I guarantee you, you will know if it is or if it ain't one up in here.
You probably got a male cat.
That's fine, you, because that's what you about to be. So, if you come this way, you will know if I got a nigga or if I don't.
Whoa.
Okay?
Why you got to use that language?
Okay.
Why you got to use that language?
Okay. Did you hear me?
Judging by your trash, I thought you would have been a beautiful lady, but you
sound
ugly.
Do you hear me? I don't even know who this is. This is retarded.
My name is
If you prank calling me, you won. If you serious, come try me and see if there ain't no motherfucking nigga around here. That'll be the last thing you do.
You got me. It's a prank call. It's a prank call.
It is.
And you said I win.
I know.
So I win.
You
can
did.
Can I get a drop? Can you say, you're listening to the worst prank call show ever? Please.
Who the fuck is this?
It's Leon. That's really my name.
Leon, why are you...
Just say, I'll explain it maybe if you say, you're listening to the worst prank call show ever.
Okay, I'm listening to the worst prank call show ever.
And I didn't take your trash.
So this is about to be on the internet?
Nah, probably not.
Okay.
I gotta go. I love you.
Hello?
Hello, is this Jayla?
This is.
Hey, Jayla. My name is Leon. I'm your neighbor here on... Hello?
Okay.
Right, and so I was going through your trash over the weekend, the stuff you had put out in that bin, and I found some stuff that I don't know if you meant to throw it away or maybe you wanted it back.
All right.
It's got your name and your number, and it looks personal. Did you want
what is it?
Well, it's just a bunch of paperwork and stuff like that. Dildos with shit stains, some underwear with your name and number on it.
Right.
I'm sorry?
I said right.
Right. So, yeah, wow. So just not sure if you wanted this stuff back. I didn't know if you meant to throw it away. I did clean it up. Everything that I wanted, I kind of put to the side and I kept in a pile. But everything that I don't want is stuff that maybe you might want back. I'm willing to bring it back.
Uh-huh. Okay. Yeah.
You appear to be one husky lady. Like, it's just too big for me.
Right.
Whoa.
Right.
What's all that in the background?
What's what?
All that noise going on in the background. Are you having a party?
No. No.
By the looks of this stuff, it looks like you have a lot of parties. That's why I asked.
Wow. Fascinating.
What's with the attitude, ma'am? I'm kind of a little bit confused. I thought maybe you'd be a little bit more grateful I called you and trying to return some stuff. Mm-hmm.
I don't have an attitude, no.
Oh.
Do I sound like I have one?
Yeah, you sound like you might have been maybe doing some drugs or drinking, and you sound either nervous or you sound like you might have an attitude.
Me, nervous, never. Oh. Never.
Okay.
I'm not nervous.
Well, yeah, so, like, I'm in the yellow house just up the street, and usually around midnights on Thursdays, I come and I just collect the trash that's out. And you had actually quite a collection of trash and recyclables, and so I took, like I said, what I wanted. And I don't know, did you mean to throw this extra, this dildo away?
I don't know. It probably just slipped my mind, you know? Just slipped my mind.
Well, do you want it back?
How about you keep it, actually?
You know, repeating things three times means you're full of shit.
You've been repeating the same stuff, sir. I don't know.
I guess you're right.
Yeah.
You made a really good point there, didn't you? The dildo.
I did.
The dildo does smell nice.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Well, how about this? So this is a new week. How about this? How about this? How about you come back Thursday?
Don't you trash can on Tuesdays, I thought?
Well, they pick up. They pick up here when they feel like it, actually.
Yeah.
You should know. You live on the street.
Yeah. Mine goes out on Thursday, though.
Yeah, yeah. Come back around. And actually, I'll hand you a couple things. You know, while I'm at it, mm-hmm. how about I hand you a couple of, I should say bullets to the body. Maybe you paramedics haul you away into the hospital. You know, ICU, hook up on a ventilator. How about that? Would you like that?
It sounds like a date. I didn't know we were going to move so fast, so quick. But
yeah. I got a nice little shootout. How about that? You like that?
I don't have a gun. I'm not shooting at anybody. And you know you can't.
Oh, but I do, you see. And I don't plan on, using it.
What kind of gun
really
do you
on
have?
Somebody. I have multiples, actually. Yes, multiples.
Big ones?
Any you want. Any you want. How about this? You come back Thursday.
Thuggish, ruggish bras.
Yeah.
Dild or not to dild? That is the question. Now, I'm thinking dild don't.
No, I'm thinking dild do. How about that? Yes.
You set that up perfectly for me.
Yeah.
I mean, we literally covered it all. That's correct. You got it right. And I think I love you.
Yeah. Yeah, how about this? I see you Thursday, okay?
What time?
Any time is suitable for me.
Do I bring the trash or should I just come empty handed? You know I've got a fetish for being shot.
Oh, really?
It's the biggest.
Do you have a fetish for caskets? You know, funeral, burial.
As long as you're shooting me with your love gun, I think I'm okay with it.
Oh yes, it holds a lot of bullets. A lot of love bullets. Mm. Yes.
Now,
can't wait to just give them to you.
Now, by chance, are you the food stamp taco lady?
Food stamp taco lady? No. No, she must live a couple other houses down. Probably not on this block.
She sells good-ass tacos.
Yeah.
But save the body bag. Let's do it raw, baby.
Oh, wow. Yeah. No. Body bag seems very.
I bet you get a bomb ass disability check.
No. See, no. I don't get disability. Yeah.
Threatening to shoot people like that, I wouldn't. I'm surprised.
Yeah, menace to society is what I was labeled as. Actually,
how old are you? Because when we started this conversation, you sounded like you were like 62, but. The more it goes on, you're sounding more like you're maybe 22.
Age is nothing but just a number, you know?
Oh.
But I tell you what, life is very, very short.
You catfish.
It depends on how you really look at it, you know?
I suppose. How are you looking at it?
Yeah. I'm looking at, mine, very long term. Yours, very short term.
You don't think I'm going to live a long time?
Mm-mm. No.
Damn.
If I'm involved,
threatening people, threatening to kill people, that's actually against the law, and shooting people is against the
law,
too?
Do you know what really, you don't know what I think about that?
You can't just shoot
don't
people
care.
Because you're mad.
No, I shoot people for fun, you see?
I mean, you're like a real short bus philosopher.
You said what?
Yeah, I know it was hard. I'll say it again. You're a real short bus philosopher.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep.
You don't know what philosopher means, do you?
No, I'm just thinking of all the fun things Thursday is going to be.
I'm not gonna come anywhere near you on Thursday. You're dreaming.
Why not?
You're dreaming. I'm gonna let you shoot me.
Why not?
Because I don't want to get shot.
It'll be fun. Trust me.
I'm just gonna come and continue to get your trash when you're asleep.
No, you see, because I will be watching you. Yes.
You're going to watch your trash all the time?
No, but when I see you, I would just make sure that our moments is just so, so passionate, you know? Like, I just want to cherish the moment.
What are you going to wash?
Of just.
What are you going to wash me
of
with?
Just you.
What kind of soap are you going to wash me with?
You just don't know your own blood.
Oh, my.
Yes.
Goodness.
I will see it run down the street into the drain as you gasp for air. Yes.
Is this Rosie Perez?
You know what? It anything. You ever heard of Griselda?
Griselda, you know, yeah. Lady Godfather?
Yeah, the Colombian. Yeah.
Yeah, I know who Griselda is. She got fucking assassinated, so that's not really a goddamn good fucking example, stupid.
Well, some of them did, but you see, I don't think you're going to make that move, yeah.
I'm not going to assassinate anybody, and I'm definitely not Griselda. And I don't think you're Griselda living in the little city that you're living in either. But if you
just
are...
don't underestimate me.
If you are...
Don't underestimate me.
So
you see, you don't make...
You sell cocaine? Is that what you're admitting to?
Anything you want to be.
This phone call is being recorded, and did you just admit to selling cocaine? And you're a godfather or godlady? You got that soft? You got that soft?
You don't know anything.
You got that hard? What you got?
No.
Oh, now you're confused. You sound like the girl that I should never date, like the girl that nobody should ever date. I bet you're probably not really even into men, which is okay.
Yeah.
One day, though, you're going to call me and you're going to ask me for a favor, and I'm going to say no.
I don't really need favors from anybody. Like I said, Thursday, okay? Thursday.
Okay, it's a date.
Yes, Thursday.
I'll be the guy that comes and sits on your trash can.
Yeah,
don't shoot me, though. Do not shoot me.
Oh, I try to. But sometimes, you know, my hand just might slip. And then something tragic.
I don't want you to go out shooting people on edge, man. I don't want you to do that. You can't just be shooting people.
Mm.
Shut that dog up.
No, you see.
Or is that your child?
He feeds off of energy.
That's your son?
My type of energy. Like I said, Thursday, right? Thursday.
I'm thinking about it.
Okay. All right.
I love you, well, Taylor.
Yeah. Love is just, doesn't exist.
Say it back, it's weird.
No, you see.
We got to go. Time's running out. But you got to say it back or it's weird. And you better bake a pie.
Yes. A pie just for you. Yes. How about a cake as well?
Okay, now hang it up.
You know what I meant? Cupcakes.
Hang it up.
Yeah.
All right, motherfuckers. That's it for now. Until next time, keep laughing.
I don't feel a single thing. Have the pills done too much? Haven't caught up with my friends in weeks, and now we're out of touch. I've been driving in LA, and the world feels too big, like a floating ball that's bound to break. Snap my psyche like a twig, and I just wanna see if you feel the same as me. Do you ever get a little bit tired of life? Like you're not really happy, but you don't wanna die. Like you're hanging by a thread, but you gotta survive, 'cause you gotta survive. Like your body's in the room, but you're not really there. Like you have empathy inside, but you don't really care. Like you're fresh out of love, but it's been in the air. I'm a past repair. A little bit tired of trying to care when I don't. A little bit tired of quick repairs to cold. A little bit tired of sinking. With a name I can't pronounce, and the dose I gotta take, boy, I wish that I could count. 'Cause I just wanna see if this could make me happy. not really happy, but you don't wanna die. Like you're hanging by a thread, but you gotta survive, cause you gotta survive. Like your body's in the room, but you're not really there. Like you have empathy inside, but you don't really care. Like your friends.